So as we have discussed till now that SICS can correct toricity by, you know, choosing correct location, length and shape of the incision. But can it give a multifocality? Yes. A recent, you know, this thing has been very recent. Since last 4 or 5 years, many of the SICS surgeons are trying this. There has been a group on Telegram and WhatsApp where we are discussing this, and still not very conclusive, but yes, few are getting results. I am one of them. Many are doing. So let's start with this March 2019 data. So right eye, patient had 3 meter finger counting vision. We did surgery of right eye by smart topical SICS, and on 6th April, it is 6-6 and N6 with a monofocal lens. This is possible. You can try this. Let's this use it as a spark, you know, to let innovation sink in this SICS, because innovation can only push us forward. So what is the hypothesis? The hypothesis is the cornea is an inherently unstable system with a vertical meridian at higher stretch than horizontal. So while we are doing the third plane of the sclerotunnel incision, we are making a visco stretch on the horizontal to make this cornea a spherical system. So that kinds of take care of the astigmatism also and induces multifocality. The exact mechanism by which the multifocality is achieved is not very clear. People are doing it, and we are, you know, in the process of trying to find out how it is being done. So let's start how we do it. So again, the same thing, using Ranjan marker, the incision on the sclera. This all is absolutely same as we do for all SICS. The only smart step is the third step, where we enter the eye. So the earlier what we used to do, we used to have a keratometry, this keroscope, which gives the inner three rings we have to see. If they are perfectly circular, we move ahead, and make a small entry in the middle, then go with a curved cannula and stretch cornea horizontally. Check again with keratoscope whether the Meyers are now circular or not, and then move ahead. So this takes a lot of time. It requires a lot of patience also, and repeated visco stretching is required. So surgery becomes a little lengthy, but yes, the time of surgery is, I think, should be the least priority for a surgeon. They should give a good result. So this is how a smart incision is made. And at the end of this incision, the cornea Meyer should be perfectly circular. Now what has happened, the doctor who was doing it has got a software, and now with the help of software, you don't have to put this keratoscope again and again. Now, the software will tell you whether it has become circular or not. So Dr. Rajiv Raut, who practices in Pune, is doing this surgery exclusively for his patients and getting good results, as he's claiming. And many of us are doing and getting results. So see, now the software is telling you where to stretch. There is an audio also to stretch at this axis, this axis. And so at the end, you will achieve a circular cornea, and your entry becomes like that, that at the end of it, the cornea becomes perfectly spherical. So this step actually takes a lot of time, but I think worth trying, must do, at least in 50 patients, and then you will see the results. So that's all. Many are doing it. I just wanted to show that people are doing it, and it has become a kind of rave in certain SICS community. So that's all from my side.
Thank you, Dr. Ranjan. I think we have Dr. Samar Basak lecture, so you will also do it faster, whatever you are doing.
Sir.
Because Samar Basak will give us many, many more teachings.
Sir.
Please. Thank you very much.